commander who can control the weather has a weapon as powerful as any Air Force. During the Vietnam War, the U.S. military began seeding clouds along the Ho Chi Minh Trail to create floods and wash out North Vietnamese supply routes. It was known as Operation Popeye, and crews flew over 2,000 spray missions.
I was told initially by a friend, he said his brother was in the military service. He said when there is these heavy spray days, heavy days when there's lots of persistent contrails to keep his family inside, when they were outside exposed, to have them go in and take showers. And he couldn't talk about it. He couldn't explain more than that.
We have extensive studies that the civilian aircraft, the airliners, were laying plumes that basically dissipated within seconds to 2 minutes. The military aircraft in the same airspace laid plumes lasting four days.
That means that in future you can take your mobile phone, stretch it, wrap it around your wrist, or even embed it in your clothes.
Embed it in your face? Your mobile phone? This is nanotechnology.
Using the new materials made possible by nanotechnology, we could build stronger houses, tougher cars, and even make ourselves healthier.
Healthier?
Medical researchers are already looking at using nanoparticles to deliver drugs or to hunt down cancerous tumors.
I'm a brain surgeon. It's my job to treat patients with brain tumors. What we would love nano
dust to deliver drugs. That's what they're doing.
That allows us to identify where the tumor cells are.
In the future, nanomedicines could patrol your body, hunting down diseases and zapping problems.
Could also work the opposite. Got a license to kill, but not with a gun. We'll spray them like bugs.
We'll have nowhere to run. We're gonna dump tons of poisons out into the air. Aluminium, strontium, barium. Stop them. It'll kill off the plants, the birds and the bees. And happen so slowly.
No one will see. Most people won't see.
Computation. There's a very conservative design for computational systems that can be the basis for building computers that are
inside your cells,
comparable in power to modern CPUs,
inside,
but occupy approximately 1 cubic micron. And
inside
putting the power
cell
of a modern-day computer, modern-day CPU, into a cubic micron lets you deliver that kind of computational power in a volume that's about 1/1000th that of one of the cells in your body.
And 1/1000th.
The says
size
something about
of
the kinds
the
of tools that will be available
of your
for
body.
Biomedical instrumentation and intervention in the future.
Another promise of this technology is to have basically tabletop factories, but factories that are not big buildings, but that sit on a table.
How this is playing in. So let me say there are three major components of this. Now that I finished this chemtrails book, because that was a book about, okay, what do we know in 2014? That's what it did. It goes all the way
from the
chemtrails and the difference between a chemtrail and a comtrail to chapter 8, where I go deeply into Clifford Carnicom's work on Morgellons. Okay, so that's done. Now I have learned, and this is very much a learning exercise, that there are three major components to this military operation. One is what's flying in the skies and being laid to ionize and keep everything ionized, and to piggyback various things like microprocessors, sensors, biologicals on the nanotechnology that is being dumped with this delivery. Second one is space, near Earth orbit. I'm not talking about Mars right now or Saturn, but space as a near Earth orbit being absolutely controlled. Okay, that's the second one. Third one the human being and transhumanism, and the future that we're being herded toward. They all fit together. They're not separate. And that's going to be my challenge. It's in the Space Fence book, I pretty much build a total picture of how it works, as if the Earth and near-Earth orbit were a machine, being built into a machine. And the third part is our genetics of the transhumanist future. And now the 5G will be coming out, and the 5G is millimeters, the tiniest, tiniest, tiniest waves. And this will shatter DNA. So these three parts are all connected. And today I'm going to spend time on the Space Fence, and I am here. I'm just reminding people who are familiar with my work. These are the seven agendas: military in nature, military industrial intelligence complex in nature. And Clifford Cardicom is the one who first thought these up. I've changed them a little bit because
weather warfare.
I've developed my ideas a little further. So we all know about the weather and the weather engineering that is going on. Then there's planetary geophysical operations, where various parts of the Earth, you're going to see them change. It's not just a matter of the salt domes down in Louisiana collapsing and huge holes opening up in highways. There are going to be various things changed with weather engineering, and that's happening in New Zealand right now, in my opinion. Then electromagnetic operations, they've discovered plasma. They've discovered how to make plasma. In this electromagnetic sky we have now, they can produce plasma entities. You'll hear about plasma orbs. You'll hear about various weird things happening, clouds that look like stones bouncing on the Earth. Plasma is the name of the game now, to discover how to use plasma, how to create it, and probably how to sell it, yes. So directed energy warfare, producing droughts in order to get nations to obey, in order to get nations to buy cloud seeding. And ionizing cloud seeding. It's a money maker, and it's a way to threaten and muscle nations into a certain behavior. Biological transhumanism, I mentioned that. This all goes all the way from Morgellons to genetic modification. Surveillance and neural operations. This is mind control, to be very brief. This is completely mind control and easy to do. And finally, the last one, which is the most far out, I suppose, the detection and obscuration of exotic propulsion systems. And when I say that, we could include UFOs.